I never knew that there was like a tiger cub that he took a photo with. There's a reason why I think this is the best album of all time, and I want to get into it in this video, so here we go.
That everybody just loves.
Boy, I couldn't say. I just created and I'm honored that the public enjoy what I do.
I love Michael Jackson so much. He is by far my favorite artist of all time. Having records to listen to music, I would love that original just like feeling of having a record, a vinyl that you can play and patiently listen to the entire album of an artist's creation.
Michael Jackson's latest, most wonderful album is Thriller.
Doggone girl is mine.
With hit after hit. Get Michael Jackson's new album now. It's Thriller.
I have with me right here my personal favorite album of all time. This is an original album, which is another crazy thing, but this is from the 1980s Thriller album from obviously Michael Jackson.
And I also would like to thank the public. Thank you very much.
Best performer of all time, greatest entertainer of all time, and this album specifically has so many hits on it. Arguably, I would say out of any album I've ever listened to, this album has the hits. So obviously Michael Jackson, when Thriller was released, was a crazy, crazy, crazy release. Absolutely changed, I would honestly say, the industry of pop music, but also Michael Jackson's kind of career. So when he released this, obviously there were so many songs. You obviously have the classic Thriller, but some of the biggest names obviously want to be starting something. Baby Be Mine, The Girl Is Mine with Paul McCartney, incredible song. Thriller, Beat It, Billie Jean, Human Nature, PYT, The Lady in My Life. I mean, you had Quincy Jones as a producer, obviously iconic, done by Epic Records. And just look at this beautiful print right here. Back in November 29th, 1982, obviously this album came out and essentially just changed the entire industry when it came to disco, because that was essentially what Michael Jackson was known for at the time. But then he started to have a mix of pop, disco, rock, funk, synth pop, and R&B sounds in this album. There's a lot of different kind of themes that kind of represented his life at the time, and also he started to have kind of darker themes within the music, so it definitely was a different feel of Michael Jackson in general. But yeah, this album is absolutely crazy. I mean, again, so many hits. It became the first number one album on the US Billboard Top LP and Tapes chart, where it spent a record 37 non-consecutive weeks at number one from February 26, 1983 to April 14th, 1984. Obviously there were seven singles, setting the record for the most top 10 singles from an album, with Beat It and Billie Jean reaching number one. 32 million copies were sold worldwide by the end of 1983. Thriller became the best-selling album of all time and was ratified by Guinness World Records on February 7th, 18 or not 80, 1984. It was the best-selling album of 1983 worldwide, and in 1984, it became the first album to become the best-selling in the United States for 2 years. So obviously, there's so many big accomplishments. It sold 70 million copies worldwide. It is the best-selling non-compilation album and second best-selling album overall in the United States, and was certified 34 times platinum, which is insane. It won a record-breaking 8 Grammy Awards. There's obviously that iconic photo at the 1984 Grammy Awards, including Album of the Year. While Beat It won 2 Grammy Awards for Record of the Year and Best Rock Vocal Performance by a Male. Same with Thriller. Man, there's so many big accomplishments with this song. I mean, especially with the producing, you had Quincy Jones, who had worked on Off the Wall with him previously. I mean, they worked on like 30 songs together, so it was an iconic duo. Obviously played with part of his family, the band, you know, with his family. But yeah, again, Quincy Jones, Michael Jackson, one of those iconic duos, makes you think of like Martin Scorsese, Robert De Niro, that kind of thing. Incredible. So, man, it's interesting. I feel like I have a mix of what my favorite songs are on the album in particular. It's kind of hard to choose just one. Like, it's hard to be like, this is the number one song on the album. I definitely will rank them out of the ones that I think are, I'll go from least favorite, or I guess like, I love all of them, but I guess it would be like least favorite to my most favorite. So I think starting off, The Lady in My Life is probably my least favorite one. Not that it's a bad song by any means, but I don't feel like it's a song that I gravitate towards and I'm like, this is my favorite. Again, I think it was a well-produced song. It's just definitely not my top one. I feel like now this is where you guys are going to be like, really? I think my next up, probably for least favorite, would be PYT. Again, crazy song, amazing drumming in that song. Pretty Young Thing, right? Vocals, chorus, just incredible. I think after that, I probably have to say, this is tough. I thought I would be able to just jump in this video and just tell you guys like what my favorites were. Next up, I'd probably have to say, Wanna Be Starting Something would be my next one. You see, Wanna Be Starting Something, it's just so good. You can just feel that beat. That's something that I love about Michael Jackson's songs, is like you know the beats, and they're fun to dance to, obviously because they have that disco kind of feel to it. Next up, I'd probably have to say Beat It, followed by Billie Jean. Probably have to go with The Girl Is Mine, Thriller, and then Babe Be Mine is actually, and Human Nature are probably my favorite out of the two. I'd probably say Babe Be Mine is probably my favorite, and then Human Nature. But Human Nature to me is like probably one of Michael Jackson's best songs of all time, because I think it's such a beautifully sung song, and his voice really is the only voice that I think could really do this song justice. Obviously, he created it, but incredible. But man, what bad things can someone say about this album? Like, I know there are so many albums that you could say, okay, they are incredible, but like, if you were to put this album up to today's music that we have, if you look at, you know, the likes of Travis Scott, I don't know, I'm just trying to think of top people right now, Kanye, Olivia Rodrigo, like the bigger names that you think of, Morgan Wallen, Luke Combs, like, I don't know, just, I'm naming people right now, but like Post Malone, but I don't know, if you put this music next to those, I feel like arguably there's nothing that you could say that this would not still be one of the best albums. Like, if this came out today, I still feel like this would arguably be some of the best music that would have come out. Like, if no one knew who Michael Jackson was and this album came out, I think it would just absolutely, like, people would be like, wow, this guy is phenomenal. So, man, what an iconic album. But again, this really is more just a tribute to Michael Jackson. I absolutely love his music, just the person that he is, and there's always those people down in the comments who make accusations. I don't believe any of those, and I'll stand to the day I die defending Michael Jackson and just the impact that he's had on my life in music, and also the amount of just charity and things that he's done and did in his life. So, a legend forever, the king of pop. Let me know down in the comments down below, or what is your favorite album of all time? Do you guys have a favorite song from this one, the Thriller album here? Thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate it. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out. Bye.